and welcome to church once again. How are you today? Did I hear fine? Or okay? Or maybe I'm doing great? Well, awesome. If you weren't feeling grand because of something or someone, I sure know that our teaching today will make you smile. If it's your first time, we are so glad that you are here.
Welcome, welcome, how do you do? I'm so glad to see you. Sit down, all in a ring. Hold each other's hands too. Happy, happy, that's how we feel when we are together. Happy, happy, when we are together.
We've been learning from Daniel's fascinating story, and we will dive a little deeper today. If it's your birthday this week, please stand and shout. Yeah! Let's sing you the birthday song. We wish you a very happy birthday and an absolutely brilliant new year. Now, let's pray. Heads bowed and eyes closed. Heavenly Father, we thank you for another beautiful day. We ask that as we are here, that we will learn something new from you today in Jesus' name. We also pray for everyone celebrating their birthday this week. Father, give them a wonderful blessing and a wonderful gift. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Wonderful, wonderful. things bright and big, all creatures great and small, all things wide and wonderful, the Lord will be prepared. Each piece of light and hope, each piece of bird and sea, he made you glowing color, he made you bright and big, all things bright and beautiful, all creatures great and small, all things wide and wonderful, the Lord will be prepared. It gives us time to sing, and in that we might sing, our praising God Almighty.
Champions win in sport aside from trophy. Medals. Can you tell me how many types of medals we have? And what position each medal winner takes home. Yeah? Okay, I'm gonna let you know. So first place wins gold. The second wins silver. And the third wins bronze. If you bring one of these medals home, whether it's bronze, silver, or gold, you, my friend, are a hero. Our verse of the month is from Philippians chapter 3 and verse 14. It says, I push myself forward toward the goal to win the prize. God has appointed me to win it. The heavenly prize is Jesus Christ himself. So friends, we're going to do an activity with our verse of the month now. What we're going to do is the first part of the verse, we'll take it slowly. The second part, we'll take it really fast, like we're rapping, right? But I will do it first. And then the second time, you can go along with me. Ready, set, go. I push myself forward toward the goal to win the prize. God has appointed me to win it. The heavenly prize is Christ Jesus himself. Who else can take it as fast as I did? Or just like I did? Okay, so one more time together. Ready? Go. I push myself forward toward the goal to win the prize. God has appointed me to win it. The heavenly prize is Christ Jesus himself. Oh my gosh, that was so much fun. As Christians, we should focus on Jesus and the good things he has for us. Just like Paul, who used to be mean to Christians but changed for the better, we should also let go of our mistakes and keep looking forward. Who has heard about the story of the tortoise and the hare? I heard of lots of funny stories about tortoise growing up. Okay. So this particular story is about a race between a speedy hare and a super slow tortoise. Now, during the race, the hare became too confident because he was way faster than the tortoise. He took a break, can you imagine? But the tortoise stayed focused, and guess who won the race? Yes, the focused tortoise. Now, even if we have to let go of our mistakes like Paul, don't think it is a good place to stop. We need to stay active, and we should always keep trying our best to stay faithful. Now, sometimes we might think we know everything about Jesus, but learning about him is a never-ending process. We should always keep seeking Him. Let's be like the tortoise, always looking ahead to our goal, staying steadily on the road, not wavering, right? We should remember that Jesus died for us and promised us eternal life in heaven. Our race is not over. No. It is not over until we reach that goal. Now let's keep going, stay strong, and read the Bible to help us along the way. So last week, we learned about a group of young men who knew the value of a good diet. Now, after being offered the rich and fatty food of the king's table in Babylon, these young men insisted on eating a diet that was not only healthy, but in line with their faith in God. Daniel and his friends were rewarded not just with physical health, but with spiritual health also. They set a powerful example for us to follow as we strive to honor God with our lives. Now, just like Daniel and his friends, we should also be careful what we take into our bodies. The things we eat and drink are taken in through our mouths. The things we hear are taken in through our ears. And the things we see, read, and watch are taken in through our eyes. We need to take in the good stuff, you know, like read the Bible as much as we can, and let the Word of God fill our hearts with love and goodness. We also need to be careful, very careful. Now, this is very important, friends. We need to be very careful about the books we read, the TV shows we watch, the websites we visit, the music we listen to, and the games we play. All these things we put in our minds feed our souls, and just as junk food can hurt or weaken our bodies, the wrong kind of spiritual food can hurt or make our spirits weaker. We need to take time to pray. We also need to take time to exercise our faith, because the way we exercise our bodies on the sports field is just the same way we should exercise our faith. The more effort we put into feeding our souls, the stronger our spirits will be. So tell me, what sport do you think should be in the Olympics one day that isn't already in it? Cricket? Polo? Bowling? Darts? Squash? I think video games, because they are like an incredible sport and it's growing really, you know, wildly. So that would be an interesting one to have, video games in the Olympics, yeah? But every athlete who sets out for the Olympic Games leaves a little extra room in their luggage. Do you know what goes in there? They are hoping to come home with a little something extra. And many athletes trade souvenirs with their fellow athletes from around the world during the games. But that's not what they're after. Can somebody guess? I'll help you. They want the treasure. They want a big hunk of gold, silver, or bronze, or a ribbon of some sort to bring home to their country. So whether in the Olympics or in sports day in your school, winning a medal is an achievement no one can take away from you. It's a task that can seem almost impossible to those on the outside. And it takes loads of preparation and a whole lot of hours of practice. Gold is the ultimate goal, but most athletes are more than thrilled to bring home silver or bronze. It's an honor to even compete at the games, and to receive a medal is a moment no athlete ever forgives. So last week, we met a young man named Daniel, who had a goal of honoring God with his life. And I personally think that we all should have that same goal to honor God with our life. So Daniel first made a name for himself by refusing to eat food offered to him by the king of Babylon. The king was called Nebuchadnezzar. Now he asked instead to eat a diet that was not only healthier for him, but one that was in line with his faith. So Daniel was rewarded for his courage and faithfulness to God that day. But soon he faced an even greater challenge. King Nebuchadnezzar had a dream that made him worried. When it became apparent that his usual advisors had no real clue what the dream was, he became angry. Even he threatened to kill his advisors. Daniel would have been included in this sad punishment. But while others shook in fear, Daniel saw another opportunity to honor God. King Nebuchadnezzar dreamt of a statue made of gold, silver, and bronze, as well as iron and clay. He did not believe in God, but he knew this had to be some sort of message from above. Now the king quickly realized, as his advisors begged him to tell the dream, that they had no clue how to help him. That's why he made the unrealistic demand that whoever interpreted the dream had to tell him the dream first. Was that an impossible task? Yes! For a human, it was impossible. But Daniel had Almighty God on his side. Daniel prayed, and God gave Daniel the dream and its meaning. God used his faithful servant to not only deliver a message through the dream to the king Nebuchadnezzar, but to show that nothing is impossible for those who seek to honor God with their lives. Daniel didn't hear the king's sad punishment, race up to his room, and pray for the first time in 6 months. No, he didn't. Daniel already had the daily habit of spending time with the Lord. He was in excellent spiritual condition because prayer and reading scriptures daily were habits for him. Daniel did not panic when he heard what the king had demanded. He took the matter to God, the same as he did everything. It was another day, another prayer, another opportunity to honor God with his life. None of us are likely to ever be faced with a challenge like Daniel's, but we all have challenges every week. We face challenges at home, in our friendships, with our family members, and even with tasks. We face challenges at school, in the classroom, and on the playground. We are challenged to stand up for what's right. We are challenged to stand up and defend the weak. We are challenged to stand up and choose to be good, even when everyone is being naughty. We are challenged to live a life that honors God by loving others and standing up for our faith. Now, if we prepare for the challenges beforehand, we can conquer them every time. The way we prepare for every challenge is to read the Bible, pray daily, and keep our hearts and minds focused on God, not on cartoons or video games, but focused on God. We will take our challenges to God, just like Daniel, and after God gives us victory, we will give him the glory. God is bigger than our challenges. He is powerful enough to help us overcome even the most impossible challenges. Have faith, and God will give you the victory. This week, we have learned that God used his faithful servant Daniel to not only deliver a message through the dream to Nebuchadnezzar, but to show that nothing is impossible for those who seek to honor God with their lives. The Bible is the nourishment we need to have a healthy spirit. We should develop a daily habit of spending time with the Lord like Daniel. He was in excellent spiritual condition because prayer and reading the scriptures were his daily habits. We all have challenges every day, every week, but God is bigger, way bigger than our challenges. He is powerful enough to help us overcome even the most impossible challenges. Finally, we should always take our challenges to the Lord, just like Daniel. And after God gives us victory, we must give him the glory. Every week we have a challenge, and this week our challenge is to put these things to practice. Please ensure you read the book of Daniel chapter 2. Make medals out of foil or construction paper. Punch holes in the medals and thread some string through them so you can wear your gold or silver. Bring it with you to church next Sunday, or take a picture or video of you wearing your medal and email it to us at seeds@elevationng.org. This serves as a reminder to us that nothing is impossible with God. Now, let us pray. Dear God, thank you, God, for your amazing, awesome power. We ask you to reveal your power and strength to us. Help us to develop a daily habit of reading our Bibles, praying, and focusing on you. Amen. Some people have written us to say that this teaching blessed them and would like to give an offering to God. The different ways by which you can give are now displayed. Please note that this is optional. God bless you. Now, let's check out our pop quiz for today. Ready, set, go. Dash dreamt of a statue made of gold, silver, and bronze, as well as iron and clay. A. King Solomon. B. King David. C. King Nebuchadnezzar. D. King Saul. The answer is C, King Nebuchadnezzar. Dash was in the daily habit of praying and spending time with the Lord. A, Eutychus. B, Aaron. C, Philip. D, Daniel. The answer is D, Daniel. The king was dashed when no one could interpret his dream. A. Worried. B. Happy. C. Eaten. D. Joyful. The answer is A. The king was worried. Reading our dash daily helps us to have a healthy spirit. A. Novels. B. Bible. C. Comics. D. Magazines. The answer is B. Bible. If we prepare for challenges beforehand, we can conquer them every time, true or false. The answer is true. We can read our Bibles, pray, and focus on God to conquer any challenge. The wise men told Daniel the dream and its meaning. True or false? The answer is false. God told Daniel the dream and its meaning. Nebuchadnezzar told his advisors the dream and they understood it. True or false? The answer is false. Nebuchadnezzar did not tell his advisors about the dream. With God, dash shall be impossible if we have faith in God. A. One thing. B. Nothing. C. All things. D. Some things. The answer is B. Nothing shall be impossible with God. Does God still do the impossible for his followers? Yes or no? The answer is yes. God still does the impossible and helps us with our challenges. We should always take our challenges to dash just like Daniel. A. Our friends. B. God. C. Our cousins. D. Our neighbors. The answer is B, God. Just like Daniel, let us take every challenge to God. Remember that you can watch all these teachings over and again. Till I see you next time with another amazing story. Remember to power up your spirit by feeding on the right spiritual food. Don't just say the right thing, but do the right thing. I love you, and God loves you more. Bye, friends!